wonderful time with me, Funmi Ajayi, on the program Virtuous Woman, a weekly program from the stable of Glorious Vision Television that I love watching. Oh, we give God the glory, because if not God, we won't be here this week. Last week we went and we said, if God studies, we will be here this week. And this week we are here in His presence. We give Him the glory. As you all know that I don't always do the program alone. I always have guests doing justice to any topic we want to treat. And this week is the same. I still have a guest on set with me. And the set I have this week is a public servant and a teacher by name, Dickness Esther Faith Winner at DBC. Madam, you're welcome to the program, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome, ma.
Thank you.
The topic we'll be looking at today is very, very interesting. And by the time I tell you, you will believe with me that it is interesting. And the topic is speaking well of your spouse to other. Speaking well of your spouse to other. So, madam, once again, I say welcome to the program.
Thank you.
And I'm sure that at the end of this program, God will take control and others will definitely learn from us. So the word spouse means what, ma?
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
A spouse is a partner in marriage, that is, husband or wife.
Okay. So it could either be husband or wife in marriage. Okay. So, and let's say, what do we mean by marriage? Because just a husband and in marriage. So the word marriage means what, if I may ask?
Marriage is a union between a woman and a man.
Okay, well, let's say two adults coming together now, because when you say a woman and a man, they should be adults. Okay, so like we said, we are looking at speaking well of our spouse to other, and you said spouse is neither a man or woman. Okay, now talking well of our spouse. The word talking well means what? Let's simplify it so that viewers at home can really learn from us.
Thank you, ma'am. Before we move on, I would like to explain the key words.
Okay.
That is talking and well.
And well, okay. So the word talking.
When we say talking means to speak, to discuss, to communicate, or to give certain information. Now, when we say well, well means to present something in a good or right way, or in an acceptable way. So when we now join the two together, we say talking well means to speak or to give good information about particular thing.
Okay, now giving good information about particular thing or particular person. Now let's go, because we say talking well of our spouse. So in a nutshell, we want to say, as in talking well means giving good information about our spouse, which can either be the man or the woman. So what? Okay, we've known now. So what can warrant you not to speak well in the first place? You know, is the marriage that you've come together? You are two, the husband and wife, you are together. So what do you think can warrant in the first place that you won't speak well of that spouse?
I don't think that anything should warrant us to speak negatively about our husband or our wife.
Interesting.
Even if you know that your spouse is doing something that is bad, it's not that you will carry that information to the third person. You have to settle the matter amicably within your family. Though at times it is difficult to settle such a thing. So when you see that you cannot settle it maybe by the word of your mouth or by your own wisdom, you may still go on your knee.
Really?
In order to settle
I like that. For example, let's take for instance a wife beater. Don't let us be too spiritual in this question I want to ask you. It does happen. Forget about being a Christian.
So
a
Christian.
Yeah. You see a man beating his wife always. And how would that wife now carry that with the mark on her body out there to still go and speak well? Because you said there should be nothing that should warrant speaking negative about. So in that case, how would she go and speak well of the man out there?
You can still speak well about such a man. Of course.
Okay. And not I've tell the viewers. Even, not tell the viewers.
I've seen a situation whereby even a lady went to her mother to explain what is going on in her family. But I like that mother. The mother said that, my daughter, you need to endure. That's your home. Go back.
Fine.
She still came back to the mother that, my mother, I'm going to die in that. The mother said that, by the grace of God, you will not die.
But peradventure, that is a 10 of 100. We've been reading in the dailies these days where they say, in fact, we've seen pastors. I think I read those ones. And then I said the pastor, after marriage, killed her wife. If the wife has gone out, are we saying this will happen?
No. You know, at times, you need to move out for a while. It's not forever, just to settle the something. When you see that that point is going to the point of death, that maybe this man is going to kill or this woman is going to kill, because it do happen both to both at times, you may see that it may be woman that will be so stubborn. So you may separate yourself. It's not that maybe you should divorce, just to make the just to settle the matter.
And in
so
that,
and if to settle that matter is not easy. I want Yoruba, I'm so pe okunrin to na yawo eranko ni. The same thing applicable to the woman. Iyawo na to na to nse asage, because at times woman will provoke that man to the extent he will provoke. So when we see situation like that, the only thing is that just to advise for that woman to be aside for a while, not forever. It's not that maybe she's there, maybe she's divorced, or maybe he's moving out totally from that family. Just to settle the matter amicably. I've seen a situation when it gets to certain period, even the pastor just called them, that you wife, he called the two of them together, that you wife, you need to set aside for a while just to settle this matter. Because today, beating, tomorrow, beating, even to the extent that the wife was admitted to the hospital.
I've even seen the case that the wife had miscarriage in the act of
so
beating.
So even one is almost destroyed one eyes. I've seen that one.
Going back to what you just told me now, that there should be no reason why they should speak down. So in that case, would the wife still be speaking well of the...
She can still speak well about the husband. So the only thing is that it's not you should be going around to be telling everybody that, look at my husband, though. He used to do this, he used to do that, that will be shouting all those things. So, you know, by doing that, you'll be receiving different kinds of advice that will still make the situation to become worse than before. So it is better even to move on to, when you fall into that situation, just move on to your spiritual father. Okay. Let them know what is going on. Even at times, if you go to your blood parents, they may not be able to handle the case for you. So it's better to move on with your spiritual father, that you know that they can handle the case for you.
When you say spiritual father, who are you referring to?
I mean the minister of God, the faithful one.
I think I like how you ended it, the faithful one. Because that was like, there are some. Because the example I cited was the minister that beat his wife. Mm-hmm. So when you have such minister, will you still now carry your case to...
No, okay. Impossible.
I just like when you say the faithful one. Anyway, so that means... many things can warrant you talking down on your spouse. Is that what you're saying now? Or you still believe that we cannot still talk down?
We can, but it has a limit.
Okay, let's just say as a Christian, we should be able to endure.
Not to everybody, even not to your parents.
Okay. So are there people you can actually, talk look as a role model or somewhere that you can go and talk to rather than talking down your spouse?
I said this earlier, that you may go on to your spiritual father or your spiritual mother, that you know that they are role model, that if when they advise you, they will give you good advice. It's not the one that is going to destroy someone's life forever. You know, some people, when they move out like that and begin to talk about the husband or the wife, it is going to ruin the house totally. That there will be no solution again. We've seen a situation whereby the husband used to be the wife, that they say, later they said the wife should just stay aside for a while. And that person just agreed together with the woman. They were praying, communicating, committing the heart of that man to the hands of God. And later we see that the man, he came back by himself just to apologize. So, and the home was settled again.
What could have been the reason of talking down on one spouse? Because I think there should be reason for a woman to just wake up one day and say he wants to talk down or you want to talk well. You know, you talk down, you talk well now.
Yes, of course.
So, what are the reasons? Okay, what will make a woman talk well of her spouse?
What can make us to talk, that can make a woman to, or a man to talk well about the spouse? It depends on their relationship. The living together, the way, the type of love that is within them. Even if there is no love, I don't even see the reason why you will talk down your husband. Because when you talk down...
Let's clear this. You say if there is no love, will you have married somebody you don't love?
It used to happen, ma'am.
How come? I don't. As you know, there is something... someone I don't love?
There is something that we call a matchmaker. That at times we just see two people. You see them gather together and say, okay, I can, if the sister Labaja can marry brother, it will be okay.
It will be
and
okay.
And then they will agree. Why? Without love. And when you are preparing for marriage, you must say yes to somebody that you love from your heart. So maybe those people, they are thinking that it is too late for them. So that maybe all my sister and all this thing, all my friend, they have gone, it's only me or this. And they say, okay, please come and see me. See that brother that is in that place. If you marry that brother, it will be okay. I agree. Because of the situation on ground.
And there's no room and for no love.
So later no now,
when my son will always say love grows as in day in, day out.
No, ma. There should be foundation. So you build on something before your love can grow. It means that you have one foundation before. It's not that you just come together one day. So before your love, you say that the love will continue to grow. You this, though we learn, when you get married, you know, there are some secrets that you are yet to know before you enter that house. Mm-hmm. But later, mm-hmm. you begin to study one another. This, my wife is like this, my husband is like... But somebody that someone just introduced to you. When you
from
see
that,
say, I don't even know that this sister is like this. It's useless. It's
if
this,
not
this
for
brother,
so person that
not, you see all sorts of things will be coming out.
Oh my God. This is getting interesting. But we need to go on short break now. And I'm sure viewers are following us on the program. And we're talking about speaking down or speaking well of your spouse to others. Let's quickly go on short break. And when we come back, my guest is still on seat to continue from where we stopped. Just coming in, it's not the same program, Virtuous Woman with Fumi Ajayi. Before we went on break, I have with me on set Dickness, Esther, Faith Winner at DBC, and talking on speaking well of your spouse to others. I want to say thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Hey, you're just coming, just find something to sit because this concluding part you will definitely let. We've talked about who the spouse is, and she told us then that spouse are two people coming together, neither man or woman, to stay together. And talking well means appraising. And what will have been the reason why you don't appraise your spouse out there? Or what will have allowed you not to speak well of your spouse? Those are the things we've discussed before we went on break. Now, thank you very much. I want to take it now that I asked a question before we went on break that, what are the things that will make you to speak well of your spouse?
Yes.
That's the question I asked before we went on break. So I wanted to take it from that question.
Okay. What can make me to speak well about my spouse?
Yeah.
Firstly, in order to honor and respect him. You know, according to Yoruba adage, you see that only a oruko ti onigba. Back, big bye.
The way you lay your bed, you lie
it
on
means that the way you call your
husband, your spouse out
is
there.
The way the people,
will take.
So if you take your golden cup and you use it for party, people, they will use it for something that is bad
as well.
So in order to respect, the way you speak is the way the people will accept him. So when you useless your spouse, other people, they will also useless your spouse. That is the reason why you must try as much as possible to speak well about your spouse all the time.
Let's clear something. That respect, is respect a part of you saying daddy or kneeling down? Are we looking at that as respect?
No.
Okay, so the word you see, respect now, what?
You see some people, daddy or this or that or, but just outside, just from their mouth. That respect is not there. Even when they get, and at times you see those that they used to call themselves by name, Sade, Kunle, they still respect each other. But because you see some people, when visitor is there, you see leaning down, placing the table, the plate on the table, all those things, but it's just eye service.
Okay,
that thing is not within from their hearts.
Okay, let's take a biblical example of Sarah.
Sarah.
They will not say he called the husband Lord. So are we saying we should be calling Lord to show respect in this generation?
We have different kinds of name that you can give, best name that you can give your husband. Like I now, I used to call my husband my dear, and he used to call me Oni.
Wow.
So that is a permanent name. Some people, they say, why are you? So you cannot call you cannot call your husband daddy, and he cannot call you mommy. It's not, that's our own.
Me, you know my own. So my own is Iyafin, and everybody knows. In fact,
that's lovely.
And my husband is Kabiyesi.
That's lovely. So it doesn't mean, when you are saying daddy, that doesn't mean that you respect your husband. You may be calling daddy, that it is just from your mouth, not from your heart.
So definitely when you speak down of your spouse, then out there they will not respect. So are the things again that will, the advantage of you speaking well of your spouse?
Another advantage is that it is going to help the family. It can create good opportunity for the family.
Oh.
For instance now, maybe in a society, I just go there, talk about my husband in a good way, and somebody is here listening to our conversation. Wow. It's not that maybe you say, like somebody, let me give this this example before I conclude that part. I had a story about a puppy getting to school. The teacher does call the child.
Okay.
What is your mother's name? Oloriburuku.
Your daddy.
What is your daddy? Oloshi. The teacher now sent for the parent that, what is the meaning of daddy? What's your name? I'm so. Mommy, what's your name? I'm so. I say, Oloriburuku ya wo mi lo ma npe mi ni kini na Oloshi oko mi na lo ma npe mi. Look, you can imagine that.
And the children are actually learning.
Look at that. You know what is going to happen to that teacher? How is he going to feel with that about the family? So what I'm trying to say is that when you present your husband or your wife in a normal way, in a good way, it can create opportunity for the family. Maybe when they are talking about social something that in our community or in this our church, we need so thing.
They may even say that in the Bible, Abigail.
Yes, of course. Look at it. Look at the performance of Abigail. So you can say, let's send for Minister so. Because even maybe they used to fight in their home, but since they didn't know that secret, they said, it's better. Let's give them this opportunity. They will handle it well. Because whenever, anywhere you see them, you see daddy will be talking well about mommy. Mommy also, the same thing. So it means that family, they will be good for this social opportunity.
And there is a saying that says, the way you are dressed is the way you'll be addressed.
Yes.
So that means if you speak well of your spouse, they will definitely appreciate. Do we have any other thing? You just say that speaking well of one's spouse can actually bring to the home. Apart from the opportunity that you just said now, and that you sell the way you lay your bed is the way you lay. So. Do we still have any?
Another thing is that it is good. The such a spouse will be encouraged. For example, now, maybe I don't even know how to do something. So, and you see that even the husband has never made mention of that mistake that maybe when it is time for my wife to cook thing, let me use myself as an example now.
Okay.
So when I got married to my husband, they used to eat in their home town. They love this cocoyam. They use cocoyam for their pounded jam, cocoa. As for me, in my own place, we don't believe in that all those cocoyam. We believe in pure yam. And even to make that cocoyam, to pound that cocoyam, is difficult.
Yes.
So if you don't know how to do it, you will still have a little inside the something. So it takes time to teach me how to do that thing. So in the beginning, you see him, you say, just wait. Be looking at me. Oh yeah, be putting it.
Correcting inside. With love.
Uh-huh. So look at that. But if it is another man, say that. You don't know how to do that. So look at such. So you know that I too, I'm going to be, I will be encouraged to do that thing. To learn it. But if it is with rough word, I will not be happy to learn it.
No,
but my sorrow. No, no, my sorrow. I don't know how to do it.
I don't know how to do it. Okay.
So that is that will I be encouraged to.
It will encourage somebody. That's a good one. So now, do we have this advantage of speaking down of one partner out there?
Yes.
Because you've given me three examples now that it will encourage. Or do we still have more advantage before we go to the disadvantage?
I still have more.
Okay.
It also gives the spouse good name.
Good name. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So when we get to a society or church or family, the way you speak about your spouse there, it will depend on the name that they are going to call that spouse. So maybe you move on to your family house on getting there. My husband is not responsible. I'm the one that is taking care of a family. I'm the one paying children's school fees. I'm the one do the feeding aspect. I'm the one do, you know, in that that family also, they will say, he's an irresponsible man. But when you get there, even if you are the one paying school fees, you are the one doing all those that are my husband. Even before you get to the place, that where we are going, take this, and the husband say, okay. He has come. No, okay, what back? I mind pay, but the money is from the wife pocket.
Okay.
So,
all right, thank you very much. This is how far we can go on the program. So I know when we started that we cannot actually finish this because speaking well of one spouse we look at it as something small, but it's not. Probably just give advice to people that are speaking down on their spouse. Give them word of advice before we go on the program.
What I'm going to tell them that is that those people that are speaking down their spouse, they should go and change.
Okay.
The first thing is that they should endure. They learn how to endure. Because I could see that some of them is because they cannot endure.
If they endure, they will change. Okay, thank you very much. My viewers are too. My guest said, for those that are speaking down on their partner, you need to endure and change for better. I want to say a very big thank you for coming on the program.
You are welcome.
And I know that when next we call, you will definitely come and view us so we enjoy you. So this is how far we can go on the program. Is there anything you want us to discuss? Like I normally said, there is a number going on the screen. Feel free to call that number, send your WhatsApp message. I will always attend to those number. Next week is another wonderful time on the same program with me, Funmi Ajayi. Like I normally say, that if Jesus tarries in his coming, we all will be a partaker of another episode. Till then, I say keep watching Virtuous Woman.